excitement coming to the Newman Smith High School gym in Carrollton, Texas. The matches will be held on Thursday, the third day of January. The action is sponsored by the High School Trojan Booster Club, the Newman Smith High School Trojan Booster Club, and will start at 8 p.m. On that exciting card, you will see Kerry Von Erich, Stella May, Gino Hernandez, Andrea the Lady Giant, Freebird Terry Gordy, The Missing Link, Billy Jack, Crippler Rip Oliver, Fantastic Bobby Fulton, and Johnny Mantell. That's Carrollton Thursday, January the 3rd, in the Newman Smith High School gym at 8 o'clock. Time for the entrance of the wrestlers for our next bout. Let's watch. Parsons, who will team with Chick Donovan tonight against the Midnight Express. Rick Hatch is the referee of the Midnight Express. Eden and Contre with manager Jim Coronet in the ring. Trouble with Rick Hazard as the music plays for the entrance of the Iceman. Here's Chick Donovan, the Golden Boy. And I don't know where the Iceman is. The music is playing, but no Iceman. Let me go ahead and throw it to Ralph and get things started.
Falls, 30-minute time limit. On my left, with a combined weight of over 490 pounds, accompanied by manager Jim Cornette, beautiful Bobby Loverboy Dennis, the Midnight Express. And their challengers, with a combined weight of over 480 pounds, first of all, from Santa Monica, Chick Donovan. On his way to the ring from St. Louis, Iceman King Parsons. Your referee is Rick Hazard.
Well, the million-dollar question is, where is the Iceman? I don't see him on the way to the ring. And Jim Coronet is already raising Cain about this. I don't know what's going to happen, and we can't have a two-on-one bout here. We may have a forfeit. That's what Coronet wants. He's screaming at Rick Hazard. Here's David Manning out. What's the problem? I wonder if they need the house back. Manning and Hazard having words. Coronet wants a forfeit right here and now. Here's Rick Hazard. Well, Rick is telling Ralph, we'll let him tell him.
Iceman is not here.
Wait a minute, you tell the people what's going on. You look like a grave digger in that suit.
You tell the people we signed to wrestle two men, not one. If he ain't got a partner, then we win the match. That's it.
David Manning said Iceman King Parsons had car trouble, therefore Chick Donovan has a right to take on both Midnight Express at the same time.
Well, Chick Donovan says that's fine. I'll take
you
him on. It's
what
tag
I say,
team.
What I say goes. These men, I signed for them to wrestle a tag team, not one lone dude.
Now, Jim Cornette.
This match is a tag team match. Your men will tag in and out.
They're cutting somebody. There's Tommy Rogers.
You said you want to sign for two men? You signed a contract for two men? Well, you got two men right here, brother.
Tommy Rogers, who knows Jim Cornette, the Midnight Express, well. Here we go, the first fall underway. Ring the bell. A very unhappy Jim Cornette heads for ringside. And we are off and running. It's Tommy Rogers teaming with Chick Donovan against the Midnight Express. Head in the turnbuckle. David Manning trying to get out. One, two, three, can you believe it? That quick. With a very fast first fall victory, and Jim Cornette is really mad. We'll be back to see the second fall in a minute.
The show tonight, I told you the year was ending on three magnificent dates. One of them is Friday night at the Dallas Sportatorium. That's December the 28th. The action begins at 8 o'clock. Listen to this card. All at the regular price. Kamala, the Ugandan giant, faces Freebird Terry Gordy. Kamala back in. Gino Hernandez defends the Texas Heavyweight Championship against Kevin Von Erich. Kevin could again become the Texas champion. Jake the Snake Roberts faces Mike Von Erich. The Guerrero brothers face the Fantastics in an exciting tag bout. There will be a 12-man, $10,000 battle royal. I'll talk more about that later. We need to get back to the ring. Boy, Jim Cornette is very, very upset, causing problems during the commercial break. And we'll talk about that 12-man battle royal in a minute. In the meantime, we've got the second fall of a bout here that ended so quickly. Golden Boy and Rogers won the first fall. Dennis Condre is the man in the green. Eaton is the man in the orange for the Midnight Express with Cornette on the outside. I want to tell you a little about this Cornette. You already mentioned his mommy a while ago. Well, evidently mommy's got a lot of money. And evidently Cornette has been a mommy's boy all his life. Never really had to go out and get a job. He just has always had playthings. And wrestling is his current plaything. Wants to be a star. Kind of a mommy's boy. Here we are back in the turnbuckle. It's Bobby Eaton missing with a right. And Tommy Rogers is ready to win another fall here. 12-man, $10,000 battle royal of the Sportatorium Friday night. A man can be eliminated by being thrown over the top rope to the floor, by being pinned or giving in on submission. Also on this great card, all fans entering the Sportatorium, this is not just children now, this is all fans, will be given a free 8x10 autographed group picture of the Von Erichs never before sold. A collector's edition picture.
Work on it, Bobby, come on!
All fans on that card in the 28th. The picture, 12-man, $10,000 battle royal, Gino and Kevin for the Texas title, Kamala and versus Jordy tag team action and much, much more. What a week. Brandon Eust is on his way out to visit with us here. Get a chair lined up for Brian, who was very impressive in our bout tonight. Brian. Great to have you back. There's a great arm hook by Tommy Rogers. And we're going to have a tag here, or are we? Bobby Eaton over in the corner. Padre waiting. Tommy Rogers waiting to see who is going to tag in and be the legal man. There's Brian.
How you doing there, guys?
Hey, you did a great job. You bout tonight. If Hart hadn't interfered, you might have won.
Hey, I'll tell you what. This is Gary Hart. Anytime he's outside that ring, you've got to have, you need an eye in the back of your head to keep an eye on him, because he just, he's always in there starting up something. You just got to watch out.
All right, where have you been over the past month, Brian?
Well, I'll tell you, Mark, the last 7-8 months, I've been to 37 states and part of Canada, and it's just been real great. I've traveled this, you know, around the United States and Toronto, and just it's been fantastic. And I'd like to add that when you see the NWA sign, whoa, wait a second, we got it.
Boy, have we got action, and we got action. Boy, this Jim Cornette, Brian, seems to be kind of a mommy's boy.
I'll tell you what, I'd just like to have Jim Cornette for about a minute, because that'd be about all it'd take. Speaking of skinny, why don't you get on out of here, boy?
Cornette is yelling at Brian and I, and I know he's not calling you skinny.
No, I hope not. That'd be the wrong thing to do. Well, like I was saying, Mark, that NWA, anytime you see the National Wrestling Alliance sign, you know you've got the greatest array of talent anywhere in the world.
Indeed, we have, as attested to by the award winners with Main Event Wrestling. I hated to see that plaque incident, though. I know you did, too.
Yeah, that's a little bit too much right there. I'm just, it's just too much right now, you know?
All right, here's Tommy Rogers back at Cadre, back over the Donovan boat. And he really moves in the midsection. Look out, here comes Eaton. The tag, and Donovan is in. Donovan is now legal with Cadre. Brian, I hope you're on hand Christmas night, a reunion.
Well, I'll tell you what, Mark. I've had a previous engagement on Christmas night. If I'd have known that the match in Reunion Arena was coming up, I would have been there. I would have signed a contract. But when I found out about it, I was already at a previous engagement. But I would like to say my very good friend Terry Von Erich is taking on the Nature Boy Ric Flair. And, you know, these guys are just like a brother. These guys are just like brothers to me, you know. And I was growing up with them. And the thing in May at Texas Stadium, no one knew it, but I was setting up in the press box watching Terry when he won the NWA World's title. And I tell you what a feeling. I felt like I'd won it, because these guys are just like brothers to me. And I wish, when I found out that the big match Christmas night, I went out and bought my whole family tickets right there in front row so they could see it, even though I can't.
Well, I know the thrill of Texas Stadium. All of the fans who were there were. We know what you mean. Here's Eaton in now on Chick Donovan, the Golden Boy. Cadre will step through the ropes. Head smashed into the turnbuckle. Now, Brian, we've got a big 10, or rather 12 man, $10,000 Battle Royal coming up Friday night in Dallas. You've been involved in Battle Royals. You know how wild they are, and you also know how great it is to pocket that money.
Oh, I'm telling you, that $10,000 comes in handy, especially around Christmas time, right, Mark?
Indeed it does.
5 minutes into the second fall. 5 minutes.
You know, it looks like this Midnight Express has done this more than once right here, this in and out. They're working on these guys. I tell you what, they're a heck of a team.
Yes, they are. You can tell, as you mentioned, by the tagging, by the mind work. And Chick Donovan's in trouble. In fact, he's down for the count. No, he's not. And, of course, the Jim Cornette in your face wherever you go, that's another option.
Yeah, he's kind of like that Gary Hart, you know.
Here's Rogers. Rogers pounding Cadre. Of course, Rogers being one of the fantastics, they know this Midnight Express all too well.
Oh, yeah. You know, another thing I'd like to add, Mark, about this Chris Adams deal. I wasn't here when all this went down, but I tell you what, Christmas night, I wish Kevin Von Erich, like I said before, these guys are just like brothers to me. I was raised with them the whole bit, man. I'm wishing him all the luck on Christmas night, because I know the people are behind him, the fans have been great, and I wish him every bit of luck with this Chris Adams, because
this line, he's pushed it a little bit too far this time, I think.
Well, that's the truth, isn't it?
Yeah, sure enough. I tell you, man, it's great to be back in the Dallas-Fort Worth area because the fans here are the best I've ever seen in my whole life, and I've been around here about the last year or so.
Boy, Bobby Eaton just got nailed for all he's worth right above us. I thought he was going to be in our lap, and I'm going to get behind you if he falls. In the meantime, Rogers has Condre in the ring. Well, Brian, we hope you have a very safe and Merry Christmas to you and your family. Great to see you.
It was great to be back, Mark, and you have a Merry Christmas, too.
All right, take care of yourself.
All right, thank you.
Rogers, Condre. Pair in hand, and Coronet was distracting Rick Hazard to Tommy Rogers' advantage. There's Eaton stepping through the ropes, and Rogers is there and waiting. He knew exactly what he was doing. Second fall action now. We never got out of the second fall last week. Rogers and Chick Donovan. Rogers taking the place of the Iceman. Terry versus Flair. We'll be hearing from Flair later. Is it time? Make sure you're there if it is. I think it is. Good seats still available for Christmas night. Rogers to the ropes, back shoulder butt. Eaton down, left side ropes, right side, rebound, back. There's a tremendous drive by the knee into the midsection. Condre now on Tommy Rogers. Into the ropes, elbow, and Rogers is down. Here's the pin, two, and not quite three. There's the drive by Eaton. Here's the tag, far up, back. No, he's not. Rogers stopped and waited, distracted by Condre, the clothesline, and a count of three. Wow. Like Brian Anita said, these guys know what they're doing.
Winners of the second fall in 8 minutes and 42 seconds, the Midnight Express.
Midnight Express winners from the Rogers Coliseum in Fort Worth. You're watching Championship Four.
Matches are coming to the Whitesboro High School Gym in Whitesboro, Texas. The matches will be held on Saturday, that's the 5th of January. The bouts will start at 8 o'clock in the ring, sponsored by the Whitesboro Chamber of Commerce. On this card, you will see Kevin and Mike Von Erich, Gino Hernandez, Chris Adams, Freebird Terry Gordy, the Crippler Rip Oliver. I want to talk about him during the third fall. Billy Jack and Kelly Kaniski. That's Whitesboro Saturday, the 5th of January in the high school gym at 8 o'clock. Now let's go back to the ring, our third and deciding fall. All right. The Crippler Rip Oliver, the Sportatorium the other night, very impressive. The Iceman was able to gain a victory, but when Oliver went to shake his hand, mayhem broke loose. A very unfortunate situation as Oliver showed his true colors. It's Bobby Eaton stomping on top of Tommy Rogers and taking him down. Wow. Eaton riding Tommy Rogers, pulling that head back. Fans chanting, go Tommy, go. Donovan and Rogers, one fall number one. The Midnight Express, one fall number two, is a very animated and vocal Jim Cornette watches from ringside. Tamala, the Ugandan Giant, in Friday night to face Terry Gordy. Look out, double-handed chop, Rogers down.
Now talk to me, boy!
Stomped by Condre.
Come on, you want to be a wrestler?
Dennis Condre.
You ain't worth nothing. You ain't worth nothing, boy.
Yeah, punk! Coronet yelling at Rogers all the time. Two on one now. Just for a minute. And Rogers again. In trouble. Cotton Bowl six-man action coming up. Pardon to Von Erichs. Hearing from Gordy and Flair. Gets a foot in the midsection on Condra, or rather Eaton. But Bobby snakes around, but Rogers is there and waiting. Here's a tag. Over the top rope. Condra back in. Palmer jab something to the throat. Pulls him across, back, ducks under the clothesline, turns to the right. Condra bouncing off the ropes, Eaton wants in, Condra back over. Rogers calls, there's Trent Donovan ready. Refreshed and ready to Golden Boy. Elbow Condra now. But Condra comes back. Tag, Eaton will come in. Condra throws him across. Here they come, comes across with a clothesline while Condra held him high in the air. Donovan in trouble now as Eaton comes off the ropes with an elbow. Could be, might be, it is a victory on the second and third fall to the Midnight Express.
Winners of the third fall on the match in 4 minutes and 52 seconds, the Midnight Express.
We'll be back to talk to some of our stars and then go back to the Cotton Bowl when championship votes return.